from, did they come to you, or did you go to them about being a linebacker?
Boogie actually was kind of trolling me during the season last year, saying that he's going to move to linebacker, and like, I kind of like knew it was coming once the season was over. And so, you know, I talked to him, like, Dorn, and I feel like they feel like it's the best decision for me. You know, talking to my family, they feel like it's the best decision for me, too.
Did you have to do anything different this offseason to work your way into that spot now?
Yeah, I had gained some weight. Right now, I'm about 210. And so, and just also getting with Caden and Betty, doing some linebacker drills, and then just getting with them in the off time, just talking about run fits.
Knowing kind of who's been through that position, you know, what are you taking from their games and implementing into your system?
So during the offseason, I went back and kind of watched Peyton's films just to see what he did good. And then, you know, I hit him up on what we talked about, like, what's the keys to be a good linebacker, and, you know, just getting with him and watching the film, it's just going to help me excel at the playing position.
How much was that Clemson game where you filled in for him in that last try? You know, does that give you any confidence, you know, making the switch, knowing that you did it at a very high level already?
Yeah, you know, when they told me they was planning on me being a linebacker, I kind of felt like, to me personally, I feel like it was going to be easier for me since I'm more closer to the line of scrimmage, and I don't have to do as much covering as I did at safety. But like I said, I feel like it was going to be easier for me if I just did the transition.
How much have you heard the name Jermaine Pratt in the last few months?
I've seen it on Twitter. I really haven't heard it. Like, my coach really didn't say nothing about it, but I have seen it on Twitter that, like, he could be a next Jermaine Pratt.
Do you know the legend at all?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you hope that could be you?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I just want to be Sean Brown. You know? I want to be my own guy. I want to build my own legacy. So that's just kind of what I want to do.
When you talked to Peyton Wilson about some traditions, what kind of advice did he give?
He just kind of talked about, like, you know, at the real position, you kind of got to be quick on your feet, you know. You got to make decisions, like, right then and there, you know. You can't really hesitate, and then whatever you do, just do it full speed.
Pretty much so. You talked about having less coverage responsibilities. He was one of the best coverage linebackers in the country last year. I mean, did you pick his brain about that, or do you feel pretty comfortable with the coverage where you're at?
Well, at that position, you know, it's really either I got to do this or that. And so, like, I feel like it's kind of, like, the same, but, like, kind of it would be easier. So that I didn't really ask him about that.
Moving out of the safety room, and kind of excited to see some of, like, the younger safeties kind of step up in the role.
I don't know if y'all was out there, but Zach got a pick. So I was very excited for him. And, you know, Brody and then Torrente. So I'm just, you know, Torrente has been meeting with me, asking me about the free safety spot. So I'm kind of excited to see how they do.
When you look back, I mean, in the beginning of the year, they would take you out in the nickel or dime. But by the end of the year, you were doing really well on pass coverage. How much do you feel that you improved as a pass defender last year?
Well, I kind of knew that was one of my weaknesses. And, you know, in practice, Coach Dorn always tells us to have a little more. So when we're in practice, I just kind of harp on, like, my coverage is really as man or zone. And so it was just something I really focused on getting better at. And then